Applying procedural effects when modeling the hair is very important because they allow you to make quick changes and preview them in real time. The procedural effects in Ornatrix are done through the variety of modifiers that you can apply on top of the hair, as is evident on this stack here that I used to create this quick hairstyle. However, sometimes you may want to clamp down some of these changes and bake them down to a single modifier that can no longer be edited procedurally. There are a number of reasons why this may be needed. For example, you may want to speed up the evaluation of your operator stack by just having a single modifier instead of multiple ones, or you may want to remove unnecessary flickering or some kind of jittering during animation if it's related to one of the operators like freeze or curl that keep deforming incorrectly or adding some jerky results due to the character movement and the hairs flipping around. Or you may just want to prevent people from modifying the operator stack, or even maybe you want to preserve the hair shape and kind of lock it down to be the final shape of your hero character. So as of Ornatrix version 7, this is quite easy to do. All you have to do is to select a modifier that you want to start baking from. So in this case, maybe I want to create two separate baked sets of operators. First one would be edit guides here, going into strand freeze, and second one will be these two operators over here. To bake operators, you select the very bottom operator that you want to start baking from, and you disable all the operators that you don't want to be baked that are above this. So in this case, I'm going to select hair from guides and the rest of them at the top. I'm going to right click and select off. And then I'm gonna go back and select my edit guide. So in this case, edit guides and everything above it that's on is going to be baked. In this case, edit guides, curling, and frizz. As you see right now, frizz is procedural and so is curling. So these operators keep being applied on top of the edit guides if I make any changes. And if I bake them right now, I'm gonna have a single edit guides node. So let me do this right now. I'm gonna select the edit guides, go to Ornatrix main menu, and I'm going to select Bake Modifiers option. When I do this, all three operators are getting collapsed into a single Edit Guides modifier, and this modifier captures the changes that were made by those three operators into this single one. I can change the apply amount to 0, from 0 to 100, and you can see that all of the changes that were previously done by those three operators are kind of being applied by a single Edit Guides instance. This is very useful because the changes are now in object space, and if the character was animated or something else was going on, the changes would be applied very predictably on top of the hair. Now if I apply the rest of the operator stack, if I turn it on, you can see the changes did not get affected, the hairstyle is still the same, and this edit guides kind of locked all those procedural effects that were done below the hair from guides operator. So let me just repeat this process just to show that this can be done on hair as well as guides or really any other part of the operator stack. So I'm going to select clamp and I'm going to turn off this change width operator over here so they just clamp and strand freeze. The two parametric operators are going to be baked into a single baked guides here. So I'm going to select this, go to Ornatrix main menu, bake modifiers, and those two operators are replaced by edit guides and the output has not changed. If I turn this back on and I play with the amount, you can see that the clumping and the frizz that were applied to the outlier hairs is still preserved. And because this is edit guides, it's actually modifying the input hair. I can turn this off or on anytime I want, or I can go to my hair from guides and I can change the input strand count, and it's going to be applied correctly with the edit guides that was baked to my hair. Again, this is very useful because you can bake more than just the hair shape. You can also bake things like strand groups or rotation or any other changes to the hair or the hair data that were created using one or more operators. So this feature is very powerful in providing you many options of how to deal with your hair by allowing you to simplify it or collapsing multiple changes into a single modifier.